Welcome back to yet another video about being intentional, about living the life that you are actually meant to live. Today's subject is admittedly huge and complex and may not have a definitive answer. And what it is we will explore in this video, which is a little bit longer than usual, why is the world the way it is? Now, admittedly, there's a subtext to this question, and the subtext is that the world somehow ought to be better. It ought to be easier to live in. It ought to be easier to work in. It should perhaps create less friction for us as we try to fit into it. Now, if we accept, which we must, that the world is essentially an emergent phenomenon, so what we experience as a local or a global culture is something which arises out of the collective actions and beliefs and values of the collective, which is made up of all the tiny little systems which make it up. You know, us individuals as a system, the family units we belong to, the communities which we live in, the workplaces which we're part of, the cities we have, and the countries which are created around those cities. All those things collectively make up the world. This leads to a conclusion which is a little bit disturbing, perhaps, in that essentially the world as a system has its own logic, and that logic is blind to our own specific needs, wants, desires, and requirements. Essentially, we don't exist for it, and we don't exist in its sort of operational system and the things it takes into account. This kind of sounds a little bit fatalistic because it leads to two conclusions. First of all, the world is the way it is because that's the way it should be. So if we see things which disturb us, for example, if you live in my world and you see the same things that I see, and you see perhaps that democracy everywhere and democratic values are under attack, authoritarianism is on the rise, autocracy and autocratic tendencies are on the rise, work rights and individual rights are being eroded. Now, if you see all these things which are disturbing, you may think, well, you know, the world should be better. And the argument here is that, yes, if we all feel that way, if we all strive for a better world and we are failing to produce a better world, then the world is exactly as it should be because it's the outcome of the systems we have in place. So essentially, the things which we disagree with in terms of the thing which we call the world are systemic outcomes of the operational system of the system which we have in place. So this may sound a little bit fatalistic. It may sound like, you know, individually we are helpless and arguably worthless, and we can't do anything to change anything. And, you know, the massive sort of colossal thing, which is the world, will grind on whether we exist or not. At a certain point, that is true. But it is also true that since it is made up from the collective, which is us, since our values and beliefs and actions lead to the creation of the world, those values and beliefs and actions can also change it. So now you'll ask, well, what can I do? What can any of us do to actually lead to this better world which we expect to live in? I can't be very prescriptive here. Excuse me. I can't be very prescriptive here because essentially, every one of us is in a different place, experiences different needs, and lives under different pressures. However, what I will say is that if we're consistent in our values, if we truly think and understand our principles, if we really think about the things which are important to us, and we live according to those ideals we have, those beliefs we have, those principles which guide us, and if we try constantly to exercise our judgment where right and wrong are concerned. And are trying to constantly, and I say trying for a reason here, to always act for what is right, then collectively, regardless of what we experience right now, the world will move towards this better place we actually expect to see. Now, there are other reasons for this. These are really complex, and perhaps, you know, this is not the kind of video which I want to go into because it will make it unnecessarily long. However, If we disregard those complexities for now and just focus on the consistency of our actions, then we will have faith in ourselves, which means we need to think about who we really are. We'll have faith in the people around us. We'll have greater trust in the way we connect and work and live with each other. And these things are transformational. They bring about change in small ways that leads everything the right way. So if you're wondering why is the world the way it is, well, the short answer is because it is exactly the way it should be. And if you're asking yourself, what can I do to make the world a better place? Well, the short answer to this is be a better version of yourself. Be a better person in every way you can. And if you do that actively every day, in small ways or in big ways, it is entirely up to you, then you should have faith that everything will evolve towards the way it should evolve, and that will be a better place, a better world, and arguably perhaps better people in it. I hope this helps. I hope this helps you think about some things. Stay safe out there.